In this peaceful spot by the River Brent in West London, St. Mary's Perivale has stood for nearly 900 years. Surrounded by its peaceful churchyard, it has survived storms, wars, famines, plagues, and even developers. Acquired in 1976 by a charity set up for the purpose, it has now become one of the most important classical music venues in Britain. We're too small for orchestras, but our size and acoustics give us a perfect venue for chamber music and instrumental recitals. During the recent pandemic, we were not allowed to have a live audience, but we have not only survived, but actually thrived by live streaming our concerts. Now, we are thrilled to be able to readmit an audience, but the live streams continue as an essential part of our offering. So, wherever you are, enjoy this concert. And please consider donating via our website. Thank you very much indeed.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We have a good number of you here in the church today, so thank you all for coming. And welcome to our online audience. Thank you for joining us. Today, Tuesday, of course, it's the piano recital, and it is the turn of Julian Trevelyan, a British pianist who has played for us several times before. Those of you with programs in the church can read his biography. But if you're interested online, then please go to our website and read his very impressive biography. And that includes his second prize, his silver medal, in the Horowitz competition this year that was played in April in Geneva. So welcome, all of you, and let us now... I should remind you of what the program is for the online viewers. We have two big pieces today, the Prokofiev Sonata in A major, number 6, that has got 4 movements, and that's then followed by the Schumann Fantasie in C, opus 17, and that's got 3 movements. So let us now welcome Julian to the piano.
Good afternoon and welcome. I don't usually start my recitals by speaking, but as the first piece in this program is Prokofiev's 6th sonata, one of his 3 war sonatas, I think it's best if I explain a bit before I play. This piece is, for me, one of the best pieces of Prokofiev. And it is built upon the idea of what is music? Music of war, or music for war, or music against war? Each of the movements shows a different facet of this idea. So the first movement, we start with some unusual things happening. The music doesn't start immediately. There are rests and hiccups. Both hands are playing consonantly, not dissonantly, but together they make dissonances. He has a tritone in the left hand. And in the right hand, he has just a normal, but it happens twice at the same time. So each of these notes together sound wonderful, but when they are together, they are more conflicting. As this movement proceeds, the horns, as I call them at the beginning, they come back again and again. The second subject is a kind of reprieve, but in the development, we have a kind of machine gun fire and bombs which fall amongst all the themes which get mixed together. And finally, a section which comes at the beginning based on the James Bond theme, or maybe the James Bond theme is based on it. I won't tell you which. So that comes back at the climax where everything just falls apart. Hopefully not me, the music, I mean. So that's the first movement. The second movement, I was very interested. I have given some masterclasses in Indonesia. And one of the mornings, I got up at 5 o'clock in the morning to go on a boat and see the fish markets. And there was some music playing, and I asked, what was this music? In fact, it was the music for the police. The police were doing their training exercises. And it was music from the 1940s, written at the time of the Indonesian Independence War. And apparently it's quite similar to the music that Soviet soldiers and policemen would have been listening to. So the first movement is a description of war itself, of battle, of artillery. The second movement is training. Then we have a third movement, which is a waltz, which is based on various themes from Tchaikovsky's Fifth Symphony. And this is sort of a dance of memories of those people who are still alive, maybe trapped in the ruins, we don't know. It's the emotional center of this work. And what can we do after the emotional center? Well, Prokofiev says, let's mix things up a bit more and write a movement which is based on a theme from Beethoven, the Appassionata Sonata. Here, we hear again the chromatic lines of the first movement, and the main theme comes back again in a kind of cyclicity which links sort of the terror of those fleeing with all the rest of the work. And Prokofiev wrote this during the Second World War, but we can very well imagine the same scenes happening today. And people often find this music hard to listen to. And I would agree that it's not easy to listen to. But if Prokofiev is writing something about war, we shouldn't find it easy. He's not trying to show us something to appease us. He's trying to show us something that we don't necessarily have in our lives. And this is one way of letting us think about it. I will never forget that in 2013, one of my mentors said to me, as long as you haven't stopped a war with your playing, you're not playing powerfully enough. So, now that I've described a war, I have stopped that war, but that's just the war of my playing. But art and musicians have a job to speak to the hearts of other people. And with my playing, all I want to give is connection and peace. And that is something we should all wish for in this world.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Julian, for your tremendous performance today. That Prokofiev really was something. And I think your fulsome introduction and explanation of it added much to it. So thank you for that. And then the beautiful Schumann, of course, it gave a nice balance overall to the concert and the encore. So thank you very much indeed. Actually, during the performance, there were a number of comments during the Prokofiev on the online chat. And somebody was asking, what is the technical term for a page turner who doesn't actually have any pages to turn? And somebody suggested maybe it's key tweaker. Somebody else says it must be button pusher. But in any event, let us thank Julian's father, Sir Peter Trevelyan, for turning the pages today. So now at Perivale, we are, and particularly for the benefit of the online audience, we're going to have something of a half term. So there will be no concert on Thursday and no concert on Sunday. And we return in a week's time when Michał Szymanowski flies in from Poland to play an all Chopin recital for us, 2 o'clock next Tuesday. So we can look forward to waltzes and ballads and nocturnes and mazurkas and, of course, the famous barcarolle. And then next Thursday week, Michael Petrov, the cellist, returns to give a wonderful performance here as well. So I think, apart from thanking Julian again for that wonderful performance, thank you very much indeed, Julian, let me just then thank Andrew Wadcote upstairs doing the recording and the live streaming, and Sherry White on the box office here. We thank you all for coming, and of course, on your way out, we very much ask you to put some money into the box. And if you are a taxpayer, then please use the gift aid yellow envelopes. So I think that's it for this week. Thank you all for coming, and hopefully see you next Tuesday. Goodbye.